Hello and welcome back to GT scale modeling video. This video is going to be kind of twofold. It's primarily going to be a kit review, but it's also going to serve purpose as a introduction slash start video for my entry to the now ongoing 75th anniversary of the Battle of Kursk group build. If you don't know, this is a group build that's being hosted primarily on Facebook by Coen C and Nigel Wells of My Modeling World here on YouTube. And together they're running a group build which is basically anybody can join in, and it's build anything that is that took part in the Battle of Kursk. So primarily between, I think it's like July and late June, or July and early August 1943, from either of the sides involved, primarily being Russia and Germany. So with that, this is going to be my entry. This is the 1/35th scale SU-122 by MiniArt. This is their interior kit. Now, it is a last production model. See here, these themselves were not present at Kursk. However, upon doing some reading, as far as I can see, again, could be wrong about this, but as far as I can tell, there were no major variant changes with the SU-122. There were some that were attempted and tried, but throughout its actual entire production life, it actually changed very little. I believe the actual vehicle was subsequently replaced by something else entirely, which is why this particular thing never really got particularly changed. I assume there are some changes between the early, mid and late productions. As far as I could tell, I couldn't really tell what they were, and if they are, they're going to be so minor, I think, that I'm just not going to be too fussed about it. I will get myself together some reference pictures of SU-122s from Kursk as much as is possible, and from those I will ensure that what I'm doing is matching where possible. So with that in mind, I will also try to make sure that any markings I use would have been either ones that were at Kursk, or, you know, that in theory could well have been, rather than any that are particularly later conflict markings. So with that introduction, that's what I'm going to be building. At some point I may add some figures, I may turn it into a small diorama, may put some tank riders on it or put some figures around about it, but at the moment the plan is just to build the vehicle itself. However, plans change, so we shall see as we go on. So the kit itself comes with nice colourful artwork here. I have a couple of SU-122s. We've got its kit number 35208. I believe they also do an early and possibly in production as well, so you've got the choice of that. Box end, kind of standard, it's an interior kit. The box side here has some 3D CAD images from around the vehicle, showing you the interior as well, all built up. Again, there's not going to be much way to see this when it's actually built up, but we will indeed be building the interior because it's there. So this is what you get in the box. Now, don't be alarmed, this massive sprues on top do come bagged. There are lots of very small sprues here. Most are duplicates of each other, so I'll have a quick flick through and I'll just show you one example from each. But they do come bagged. This whole lot on the top here, these all come in one bag. I've just debagged them. So anything that's here that's not in a bag is in a bag. It's just I've taken them out. So I'll be back in a second when I've sorted these out. So these are all those sprues from that top layer of the box sorted out. Primarily what we've got is a lot of small parts. So I'll go through these in a little bit more detail, but generally, as you can see, we've got a lot of repeat sprues. So anything that's in a pile is repeat. So there's two of these, two of these, two of these, two of these, two of these. These are our wheels. These are shells. These are suspension parts, and I think possibly ice cleats and some kind of brackets. We've got track links. We've got the interior Christie suspension housings. I believe these are the external fuel drums. We've got what look to be torsion bar, suspension bar arms at the end. We've got idler wheels and sprockets, exhaust covers. We've got, I believe that's a roof plate. Idler wheels over here, other springs, and other small external hull parts. So again, give me a second, we'll clear this away and we'll look in some detail at one of each of these sprues. So here we have sprue FM. What we appear to have on here are some empty shell casings along the bottom here. They're quite nicely molded. There's a little bit of flashing around the edges, but nothing major. And we have some interior part. I'm not entirely sure what this is, but it could well be something to do with the ammo storage racking inside. We've got what looks to be the sort of the top of a piston of some kind. That could well be the tubing of the piston, since it's hollow. So that's quite nice, because we've got hollow parts on even a tiny little sprue like this. So that's sprue FM. We have sprue EB, which seems to have the... I always get confused on these, whether they're sprockets or idlers. I believe these could be the sprockets, because they're externally round and not toothed on Russian things. They're really nicely detailed, some really nice bolt detail. Hopefully this will pick it up on those. So they're really nice. They're nice and crisp. Those holes don't need any kind of tiny little bit of clear out maybe. So these are the exhaust shrouds. Quite nice. Maybe a little touch thick. You could maybe just thin the edge of that out with a Dremel or something if you wanted to get some thickness. I believe this is possibly one of the external grab handle rails, and what I take to be some kind of sort of lifting hook points on the exterior. This is sprue F. We have what appear to be hubcaps, springs. As I said, I think these are possibly ice cleats and other small ancillary parts, which I'm sure will become clear as you start to build. This is sprue JE. Again, there's only two of these, but it looks like it's a slave molded sprue. We've got this sort of funny shape here, so they can get this box is molded in more or less entirely, so there's no putting multiple sides together. So just a top and a front and a bottom that should go together really quite nicely, and there's a molded hole in there. Quite a simple sprue, not much on it, just this storage box. There's only one of these, so I assume it's possibly just a single external box. Sprue ED, again, just some really small parts on here. Nicely detailed. I'm not entirely sure what they are at this time. This looks like some kind of small hatch cover of some kind, but hopefully, as you can see, that even this has cast steel texture on it, which is really quite nice for such a small part, and bodes well for the rest of this kit if they're putting that attention to detail on such a small part. There's some more on the sprues. This is for JC. Some more of these little hatch parts, again with cast detail. I believe this is the roof plate. The external roof plate. So again, this part here covered in cast texture. Hopefully you'll note down the edge here we've got weld detail. There's a bit of flash on this port here, but again,
shouldn't clean out too badly. And being an interior kit, the underside has some detail wire, you know, a conduit or wire of some kind here. And I think this is the top of one of the storage racks. So the tops of shelves will go into here. Oh, in fact, I'll tell you what these must be. These must be they must be armored vision ports for on here. That's possibly what those are. Sprue FK. External fuel drums, and I said these are the sort of casings or the housings of the suspension that go on the inside of the hull, and some of the actual suspension arms themselves. The sprue seems a little more ragged. The plastic seems, it's a little bit, it's not rough, but it's not quite as glossy, if you like, on this sprue. The plastic seems somewhat stressed, like it's maybe been forced into this mould a little bit. Maybe for some reason it's a complex mould. I'm not into my plastic moulding, so anyway, nicely detailed. Sprue FJ, which we have quite a number of. These are the tracks, so nicely detailed. In fact, actually, I don't know if the camera will pick this up. In the end of here, there is casting numbers. They're tiny. There's casting numbers on each individual track link. That's awesome. That's amazing. And on the outside, just here. That's really cool. I don't know if these are track pins. I assume they might be. There's only two pair sprue, and there's maybe 10 or so of these sprues. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, maybe 10 or so of these sprues, so that would only give you 20 track pins. So I'm not entirely sure what these small pins are. And we have sprue FB, which is basically shells and casings. I think it's two-part ammunition. You put the shell in, put a metal casing in behind it that contained the actual charge. So the charge is here, and then the actual shells themselves. Nicely detailed. You won't see most of these because they're on the inside, but they're all individual. So, and then we have a sprue for each wheel. These are the inside faces. There's bolt detail and the sort of slight ribbing detail on the rubber, even on the inside faces, which is nice. And then the outside faces are nicely detailed. Oh, excuse the cat here. I have no idea whether these are the right number of bolts. Yeah, feel free to go and look it up. Some grills here. There's some really nice fine louver work here. Really nice. Some plain panels of something here. Some fine detail parts here. And whatever this is, it's... Oh, actually, that could be part of the brake drum assembly for the drive at the front. That could be what that is. And the last of these sprues is the biggest one in here, as what I believe would be the idler wheel. Again, nicely detailed. Might take a little bit of cleanup, but nicely detailed. This spring here is actually slide molded. That's pretty cool. So we've got suspension parts, more parts of fuel drum assembly, towing hooks. More suspension parts here, potentially. Yeah. So, all in all, nicely detailed there. So, we'll clear those out of the way. So, this is one sprue in here. One's wrapped double-sided in some light foam material. Again, this is in its own bag, but I just removed it. But so what we have here on this sprue is the main, well, part of the hull top and the hull bottom. So we have an assembly hull, no bathtub hull, but the internal floor plate, which has nice conduit detail and locations for the various interior parts. The outer hull sides, which have weld bead detail on the bottom, so from where this will meet this bottom plate on the outside is weld detail. Separate escape hatch. Rear deck engine vent. I'm sure there might be some photo etch to go over here, which goes in this part here, or you've got, actually the same part could be optional. So plastic molded or a piece you would put a photo etch piece in. This is the bolt frame for bolting the rear plate on. So I assume if you wanted to leave the rear plate off, maybe you could put this in place, which would be the place where that rear plate would bolt on, which is a nice detail. So this is maybe not used if you're going to close that right up so you can't see into the engine bay. But again, we'll find all this out on the instructions. So really nicely molded weld detail along here. There's weld detail all along the joins here on this kit. Bolt heads, rivet heads in place. It's really nice. There's something here, I'm not entirely sure what this is, but whatever it is has a really nice, you know, fabric texture to it. Whatever this is, I'm not entirely sure. So yep, really nice details on everything so far. Pop this back in here. In its little bed. So, onto the next set of sprues. So this is sprue C and CA. They're joined together. Just lots of really small detail parts. A lot of interior parts. I think these are parts of the steering gear. This could be, it looks like an elevation wheel, so these could be off of the actual gun assembly. We've got gas bottles, textured plate here, driver's seat, steering tillers up the top here. A lot of really fine, detail on all of these parts. Really nicely molded. More of the suspension boxes. The exterior of the rear plate. Again, with the bolt mounting holes present, so if you wanted to have that cover open, you've got the proper bolt detail. The side vents for the rear deck. Really nice and really fine small detail on there. Everything looks quite in scale. Front plate, transmission housing plate, again, really nice weld detail in there. Some very fine moulding and some very small in scale parts here. So we have sprue G and GA, more interior parts, so we're starting to deal with the, we've got the gun assembly here. Let's get you in focus. Got the gun assembly here, the recoil mechanism, the breech. This is the external part of the external housing, some really nice big chunky weld detail around there. We've got the two main sort of sides of that outer bit that goes around the barrel on the outside. Don't really know what you'd call that. Options here for this faceplate. I believe this could well be where there's a difference between the late in the early version, production wise. The only difference I can see is there's two extra beads of weld on this one that are not present on this one. So again, just a bit of research and hopefully means that actually I can build the early production version out of this, which is more suitable for the curse. You can see here, it's an interesting thing. I assume this is part of to do with the way the moulding's done. Is it? I assume that's not mismould, and it's probably more a case of the sprue gets sort of half turned somehow during moulding to facilitate the moulding of some parts, because what we have is on the sprue is also the barrel. It's really short, I mean, it's only an inch and a half long or something, but it's slave moulded. If it'll focus. It's slave moulded and rifled. I don't know if you'll see that. So the barrel is slave moulded and rifled, which is really nice. And I believe these are fuel tank parts, and oil tank and things. So again, there's still more detail parts as shells here. The bottom of a shell rack. Yep. Take the rest of these screws out of this box. Save me going up and down to the floor. Okay, so the battery's going on my phone, so we'll try and speed this up a little bit. I assume these are fuel tanks along here. I think these are the rocker covers for the engine. The flywheel, the big flywheel assembly. Really nice fan detail here. Really fine rivet detail on there. Parts of the transmission housing. The internal firewall for the engine bays, I believe. So yeah, really nice fine moulding again present on here. We've got the exhaust pipes moulded in the shape they need to be. And possibly filters of some kind. More of this final drive flywheel assembly, brake covers, piping conduit up here. I think these could be the turbos, maybe. I'm not an automotive engineer, so don't know. It's really fine. Again, there's lots of fine detail right throughout this kit. It's really impressive. So here we have the main parts of the actual casemate, so the sides and the front plate. This could well be a joining plate. Oh, that's probably the back, actually. That'd be the back of it. So yeah, really big driver's port, really big bolt holes. Again, just lots of small details places. Again, slave molding where it needs to be. Molding these little piston parts so that you can actually have that in the ventilator on top of the hull, even there with weld detail already there. And this is exquisite. The main cast gun mantlet, lots of really good cast texture on there and weld detail as well on the upper and the lower part of it, and bolt head detail. Really nice grab rails for along the sides of the hull. So, a somewhat involved build, I think, coming up. Although, I guess if you didn't do the interior, it would be much less so. This sprue seems to deal with the engine alone. So, do lower parts, the cylinder block, build it up the front of the V, the rocker covers, exhaust manifolds here, piping conduit, the mounting frame, I think. And other ancillary parts. So should build up really quite nice. So that's that. What you also get are these plastic links, which I think are probably the links that go between, because if I remember rightly, the T-34, which is what obviously this is based off, had effectively two different types of track link that link together. So these other parts, which are the non-guide horn parts, are all in these little strips. So again, just nice two nice attachment points, clean up pair one, so that should be nice and quick. A little bit of flash in places actually, but nothing that shouldn't take too much to clean up. Again, casting numbers, there are holes present in each, but I assume they're meant to be there since they're present in all of them. So two clear sprues of vision blocks, like periscopes and headlights. That's pretty much what it is, just vision port stuff, but you know, they're nice, they're clear. And a very simple decal sheet, whatever you want to call it. We just have some numbers, different types of numbers, and German crosses if you wanted to make a Butapanzer. Dropping bits on the floor. Get a little cardboard envelope with the photo etch inside. So we have the exterior engine grille with its framing around here. We have straps and tie downs for the exterior, other odds and sods, which I'm not sure exactly what they'll be for. Some small handles, could well be related to the engine and things, of course, as well inside. So yeah, nice, it's thin as well. You know, it's really, really thin photo etch. So you have to take quite care with that you're not sort of pre-bend anything, because I've always found that once it's bent, photo etch is pretty hard to get back in its proper shape. And last but not least, we have the instruction booklet, full colour on at least on the outside. So it's using sliding moulds, highly detailed model, workable tracks, full interior of transmission, full detailed interior fighting compartment, the V234 engine included, fully detailed engine compartment, 829 total parts, 730 plastic parts, 95 photo etch parts, 4 clear plastic parts and decal sheet for 3 options. So on the inside we've got colour on this page, so the photo etch sheet is basically just telling us our sprue maps, what we have. We've already seen the massive pile of this lot. Quite involved instruction sheet. Step 1 to 3, so steps 1 to 10 even are dealing with the engine. Then we move on to the transmission housing. Starting to put that together. They're still all on the interior. So there's numbers here, let me just see if I can find what that means. So we have in the little grey circles is the part number, but then there's numbers in squares, which I assume could well be paint numbers. Which is good, because it's, you know, it's giving you that colour, especially for the interior. But there's quite a lot of different colours. If that's what that is, then there's lots of different colours, even on the inside. We've got photo etch going on to the inside on the suspension, that's those suspension columns here. Photo etch going on there. You can see we've got splitting colour here. 12 and 2. Shells going in. So we're now up to step 51, and We're at step 51 and we're still on the interior. Photo etch clasps on the boxes. On the shell boxes on the inside. That's crazy. Starting to put some of the exterior parts on now, but we're still dealing with the interior as well. And you know, eventually we're still doing step 58. We're still doing interior detailing parts. But it seems quite well laid out. This is literally all you get for how to assemble the tracks. Put the two parts together, but apparently they don't need glue. So it should be a case of chopping them up and, you know, cutting them out their sprues, clean them up and just stick them straight together. So that should be nice and easy. I don't know where those little pins go though. That we saw on the sprues. Got photo etch straps here for the, oh, that's a pre-molded tarp. That's what that fabric part was. Pre-molded tarp here. Straps for all the fuel drums on the outside. And then we've just got one, two, three colour options here, but they're in colour, so we've just got two standard sort of Russian green ones. Although this one looks like it's got some faded whitewash coming off it, just from an unidentified unit of 1944. Same thing, unidentified unit 1944. Or a captured unit, captured one. Unknown unit of the Wehrmacht, Poland, December 44, in a whitewash. Colour callouts are here, so a big table of them. So that's the number they're referring to in the instructions, so that's quite good, giving you the... I've got ammo by MIG, Humbrol, Mr. Colour, Testers, Vallejo. The actual colour name. I assume this is just colour name, but in Russian. Or Ukrainian, and then the what they are. So yeah, that is what's in the Mini Art issue 122 last production kit. It's a box absolutely chocker full of plastic, which you'd expect from an interior kit. There are very few markings, but that's fine. It's a Russian vehicle, so. Again, gives you that freedom to kind of do it as you please. And everything seems really well moulded. There's good use of things like side moulding in places where it needs to be, so should be quite an intuitive kit to build and should be really, you know, really nice and detailed when it's finished. I will be building it with the interior. We'll see if there's a way to maybe just place the top of the casemate in place so that you could lift that off, enabling you to at least sort of see the interior. I don't know yet, without studying this a bit more and getting to that point, whether that's actually doable or not, but we'll see when we get there. So thank you for watching, and hopefully the camera angle's been okay. I got a tripod for the camera for Christmas, so I'm trying it out for the first time, so hopefully that's maybe been okay. I can kind of just see the screen. I film my phone, so it means it's bit annoying to sit at the side and be able to see what's actually on the screen, check them in focus and things, so hopefully that's okay. I'd be interested to hear your thoughts on this. As I said, this is also my entry video. This is what I will be building for the Kursk group build, so head over to Facebook, find the Kursk 75th anniversary group build. I'll put the link to that group build in the description. I'll put the link to my Facebook page, GT Scale Modelling, there as well. Go and take a look. That's where I'll be doing a lot of my day-to-day updates on this when I get going with it. I've got a few other things to finish first, so I won't be getting on quite yet. If you haven't already, please like the video, leave a comment, and subscribe to the channel. I recently went over 1,000 subscribers for the first time, so I'm really pleased about that and really keen to keep it going, keep it growing. I'm trying to put out some more regular content and try and make things a little bit better, touch a little bit more professional somehow or whatever, that will mean that the videos are more enjoyable to watch. Hopefully having my tripod means that I get a little bit more freedom where I can put my camera, so maybe I could be able to set it up while I'm actually doing a build. I'll maybe try it on this one, do some build updates where actually they've got some me explaining what's going on and some time lapse of the slightly more boring bits, and so you can actually probably follow along with a build, which would be really quite good if I can manage to do that. So thanks for watching. Leave a comment if you haven't already, like the video, share it, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you in the next video. Thanks for now. Bye now.